Okay, this is a program on arc length, and let's get started. To get my code in here to put the, you know, to get your my menu to come up, you have to put INDXX, which you do second alpha on the titanium for the letters, and then alpha, and then you can put the 8 and the close parentheses on there. Press the enter button and you're into my menu. Here's all the choices, goes way down here. You can find all kinds of things on here to which will help you out in your tests, your homework, your just learning about it, because it's so perfect step by step. And it's what we all wished we could have when we were looking for how to do a problem. That's why I did it for myself first, and then I'm offering it to you. Let's do arc length here. We're going to do press number 4 here, and we're going to get in. We have the parametric form, which is the RT form, you know, time and radius. And three variables, X, Y, and Z in this one. And this one is the Cartesian system, which is Y equals, which is equal to F of X. Either one will give you the function there. And so we're going to press 2 and then enter a function. Press alpha and let's put the function in here. We're going to go X cubed divided by 6 plus 1 divided by parentheses 2 times x, close parentheses, and over the range of, we have to add alpha again to get the range in here. We're going to do it 1/2 to the upper range of 2. And it shows you what you've added here, so you can correct it, or if it's wrong, or you can check it out here. I say it's okay, so we're going to press 1. Derivative of the function here is, with respect to x, is dx squared minus 1 over 2x squared. Here's the formula for the arc, the integral of over the range of a and b, square root of 1 plus dy dx squared, and with respect to x. Here we add the function into the formula here. This is the part that was squared. Here's what we did, the dy dx part, we found before. Mark all this on your paper, of course. And here we've taken the square of that. Still have the square root to do in 1 plus, but we can take the square of it first, like you would in normally doing a problem. And we're going to do the, here we're going to do the, we added the 1 to it. Here we're going to do the square root of it, which is this. Work on the formula through. Here's the, as we integrate it, here's what the integration is, and over a range of 2 and minus and 1/2. We put the 2 in our problem, 2 to the 4 minus 3 and 6 to the 2, which I show you here, equals 13/12, and when we put the 1/2 in here, we subtract the upper from the lower, or the lower from the upper. And we added the half into the formula. Here's minus 47/48. And we can see that we had a minus 47. This will trip you up a lot of times where there's a minus to a minus, so that I do it so that make sure it doesn't happen to me when I'm doing the problem. 13/12 plus 47/48. So the answer is 13/16, approximately 2.0625, rounded to the fifth place. So pretty neat, huh? EveryStepCalculus.com. Check out my other fabulous programs. You'll love them. Worth every money, worth every penny that you buy it for. It's so cheap compared to the thousands of hours I've spent on this stuff for you, studying it, making sure they're correct and everything. And remember, it encompasses Calculus 2 and 3 and 1. So you're buying all three of your semesters of calculus in one purchase. Have a good one.